Hi, my name is Joe. I'm 9 years old, and this is my 1971 Fiat 500F. Me and my dad look after it, and we have a lot of fun in it. We take it to a lot of shows, and even sometimes I get to drive it.
Obviously, a 1961 TR3 made by Triumph, Coventry, England. Built in May of 1960, registered in 1961. Thanks for having me on Petersen's Cars and Coffee, and don't forget to vote, right?
My name is Georgie Beres Pastor. I'm the daughter of George Beres, King of Customizers. You're at the Beres Custom Shop in North Hollywood. And we wanted to show you the hot rod we bought back called the Emperor. Here it is over here. And this car was a customized car. It went on to be the AMBR winner in 1960. It was built for Chuck Kerkorian. I'm gonna get in it and start it up. There you go. Proud Checker Flag members. We're so excited to be a part of Petersen and to be able to keep the history going. These were the actual seats that my father sat in, and Blackie Gigian and Chuck Kerkorian. They were the true hot rodders, and I'm blessed to keep this legacy going. So Petersen, thank you, and thank you to everyone else that's volunteering to keep everything going.
This is a 2012 Ferrari 458 Challenge car. Never actually raced in the Challenge series, but it was track day'd at Silverstone and at Spa. When the original owner put these FF Corsa GT3 parts on it, you'll notice there is a splitter down here. Above that's the dive planes, and next to that on the hood is the S-duct.
At the back of the car, FF Corsa put on one of their GT3 wings, and down low you see they install one of their diffusers.
It's a 4.5 liter V8, makes about 560 horsepower and about 400 pounds of torque.
Hello from Ireland. The little car you see before you rolled out of the factory on the 19th of September, 1957. She was one of only 300 of her type made, and today, sadly, there are only 21 of her kind left. This is the Messerschmitt KR201. This little lady spent a very pampered life on the island of Jersey off the coast of France and came to Ireland in the mid-1980s, stripped down and put in boxes for a future restoration by her former owner. I purchased the car 6 years ago and have spent that time returning her to her former glory, good for another 63 years.
Welcome to Franklin, Tennessee, home of Nissan North America. Here's my 2008 Nissan 350Z Nismo.
This is my 1930 Model A Ford pickup that has been nicely restored. I did not do the restoration, but bought it this way a couple of years ago and have really enjoyed the opportunity to drive it. We've been on several club events, some shows, and just date nights with my wife and kids. This is what we spend a lot of our fun time in together as a family, And the grandkids like it too, but it's been a fun little addition to our family, and glad to have it in our fleet.
I'm Pat, I'm from Utah Valley Model A Club, and this is my 1931 Town Sedan.
Go.
Hey guys, my name is Gavin Bumbrin, and these are my two entries for the second Global Cars and Coffee. Let's start off with my 1986 Chevy Corvette. Save the best for last. Now, we bought this car for a parts car, and we put it together because we had everything, and we had nothing better to do. So, why don't we take a look at the interior first, give you guys a good look. Now, basically, as you see, is what it came with. Champagne tan, silver trim, and black accents. Very nice. All in almost, it's all in fair condition, but it's a daily driver. Next up, let's see the heart. We are running a 355 small block Chevy V8 with a 740 four-barrel carburetor. Custom intake done by my dad, very nice job, and it's put behind, and right behind it is a T56 speed manual transmission, all in all pumping about 400 plus horsepower at the rear wheels, so it'll light them up. We'll get to starting them up later. Now let's head over to my 1940 Chrysler New Yorker. Now this is my daily driver weekender. Now, there are a lot of cool things about this car. One thing being, it's almost all original. It has the original X-frame under it, and the original brass radiator as well. Now we're running a 360 Mopar V8 out of a Dodge van. Same with the transmission rear end. It has a Jaguar XJ6 from 1989. That's very good. We have a custom license plate interior, lots of memorabilia. And everybody's favorite part, the bowling pin shifter. And I don't know whether this is the best part or if this back here is the best part. First and foremost, as you all can see, this has wheelie bars, but it has no capability whatsoever. But I got a question for you guys. You guys want a beer? Alright, so I've shown you guys the car, told you a little bit about them. Why don't we get to the real fun part, starting them up. Let's start with the Corvette. If you would just stand back there. Okay guys, that concludes my two entries for this month's Global Cars and Coffee.
Hi everybody, my name is Mario Fubianchi, I'm from Italy, and I'm the happy owner of this pretty rare British car. It's a TVR V8S 1991 made, formerly registered J342GCA. I bought it in 2013 in Chester, UK, and I registered in Italy in January 2014. The engine is the famous Rover 4 liters, 240 horsepower and 270 foot-pound. Driving is quite demanding, but also very funny, and its V8 has a lovely sound.
Everybody, my name's Mark. I'm a big fan of the Petersen. Here to talk about a 2007 Carrera. I happen to be lucky enough to also have a 2017 Macan S, but we're going to talk about the Carrera today.
So this is a 2007 Porsche Carrera Cabriolet. I got it about 3 years ago. It was one owner car, a professor in Madison. We're in Chicagoland area. He had owned the car previously. Really only updates had been BBS Porsche wheels, navigation system, and then of course paint treatments and expel to keep it looking good and fresh.
Okay, thanks for watching, and hope you enjoyed taking a look at the car. Thanks a lot. Bye.
This is a 1967 Chevrolet Impala. It has a 283 with a power glide. We originally owned one in the 60s and the 70s, but had to get rid of it. It was either keep the kids or keep the cars. It's been in a couple little fender benders, got a little body work done to it, but we just love it. And one of our favorite things to do is, since it has a bench seat in it, well, if I sit, my wife sit right next to me, I'll put my arm around her, and she can be my girlfriend. Thank you very much for watching this video of our 1967 Chevrolet Impala. Bye.
Hello to all my friends of the Petersen. This is my Jeep 2018 Wrangler Rubicon. It's a car I've had for 2 years. I purchased the car mainly on the looks. It's far more capable than I think I'll ever use. After test driving a number of different cars, including different SUVs, Cherokees, nothing was really ticking the boxes, and then I sat in this Rubicon and started to drive it, and it was just a very different experience. It's not the best car on the road, a little bit bumpy, jumps around a little bit, but it's so much fun. It is, in all intents and purposes, the ultimate convertible. It's very easy to remove the front two panels, and if you want to go the full distance, you can take the roof off, take the back off, remove all the doors, and drop the windscreen. Then you become the ultimate convertible. Driving regularly, it's two-wheel drive, but you have the option to put it in both four high and four low. If your off-roading gets a little bit more challenging, then you also have the ability to play with sway bars and axles and all that sort of good stuff as well. Being part of the Mopar family, there's so much you can do to these things. The only thing that I've done on mine is put a big brake kit on it. Due to the weight of the vehicle, I just felt it needed a little bit more stopping power. So that's my Jeep. Thanks for watching and enjoy your coffee.
This is my 1969 Camaro SS. I purchased it as my first car in 1987. Originally, it was a 396 four-speed car. The car is anything but original now. In 2012, its transition to a pro touring car was completed. The car was the cover for the June 2012 issue of Chevy High Performance. The car has a modern LS engine along with a 6-speed Tremec transmission. The motor has been dyno-tuned to produce 438 horsepower and 428 pounds-feet of torque at the wheels. The suspension has been improved with a Detroit Speed subframe and quadrilink rear suspension. The custom interior features Recaro seats, a custom console and dash with odometer gauges, and vintage air conditioning.
This is my 1984 944. Picked it up a couple years ago in San Diego. Only had 69,000 miles on it. Sunroof, delete, no sunroof. Very clean for these models. They're not really taken care of so much. Clean interior, only a few cracks in the dash. Original Porsche script seating and interior. Say hi, Dad. Very fun to drive, handles turns really, really well. I love this car.
This is our 1987 Mercure XR4 Ti. We're the original owners. It was a daily driver through 13 years of Illinois weather, during which we racked up over 175,000 miles. For those who don't know the car, it is the American version of the Ford of Europe Sierra. It was built in Germany and imported from 1985 to 89. It was arrived with a 2.3-liter turbocharged engine and a 5-speed transmission. We bought it because our 12-year-old son chose it over an Alfa Romeo Spider convertible, saying it was faster and that all five of us could fit in it. Over the 33 years, it's been through many changes. Our favorite is the supercharged 4.2-liter, 525-horsepower V6 and a 6-speed transmission. With all its changes, it's truly one of a kind, and we're very proud of it.
Hey guys, Stephen here from Melbourne, Australia. This is my 1994 E36 M3 in Daytona Violet. Fantastic car, on the road and on the track. I loved it so much, I found another one that rolled off the production line 64 cars later and turned it into a track car for me.
For your enjoyment, we are presenting a rare 1941 Oldsmobile Model 68 Woody Station Wagon 7-passenger with original wood. All the metalwork is original on there. It's been refinished. This is a 1941 Old Town Canoe on the top, ready to go in the lake. The interior is immaculate. This has won many shows over the years. It's our private vehicle for our estate here. Hope you enjoy watching it. It's ready to go in the water.
My 1993 Nissan 300 twin turbo.
Good afternoon, people from United States. Here in Canada, we're also going with the Petersen Museum and Car and Coffee. I'm not too big on coffee, so and being a French Canadian, it's easier to drink wine. So here's my first Porsche that I bought in 2014, brand new. I didn't want the car, but when I heard the noise it made, my brain stopped working and the other one took over. So I was really happy to buy this car. That's now my winter car because we do have a long winter here. So it has to be really, really fun. This one was a temporary buy. So I bought it just to have a good summer with it. And well, I guess I fell in love with it. So this is a 98 CS4. It's got a little bit of help on the engine side, so I'm roughing 300 horsepower. It's a good track machine, it's a good driving machine, and it's a lot of fun. I bought this from a local guy while I was jogging, so I saw it, fell in love with it, and bought it for the summer. This car, it's a 1966. It's a beautiful 54-year-old that still turns head and stop traffic while I'm driving around with it. It was a full restoration. A lot of love went to it. A couple of years in the making. I had a great tradesman doing it, and that's why I bought the other car while I was waiting, because I couldn't wait to drive those. This is a dream for me. When I was a kid, I wanted a 912. I like the sound of the engine, the underdog type of machine it was, it still is, so it's an underdog. It's not fast, it's not handling like a proper sport car, but it's great, I love it. It's just the fun of going with it on the road.
Good morning, Petersen. This is my 2005 Ducati 749 Dark that I daily ride in Northern California. Here is a clip of me on my Ducati outside of Lassen National Park. My favorite part about the bike is the distinctive dry clutch chatter. Take a listen. You can also follow me on Instagram at ADW Garage for more moto and car content. Happy riding!
Hi, my name is Jay Raskin, and this is my 1956 Cadillac Series 62 convertible coupe. Last year I had my rear bumper re-chromed, and here is my restored trunk. Here we'll do a quick walk around the car to see it from all angles. I had the interior redone, reupholstered shortly after I bought the car in 2001.
Last month, I finally got my very own classic, so this is our very first car show together. This is an all-original 1957 Ford Custom Ranchero with two-tone paint in colonial white and doe skin tan with dog dish hubcaps. It was previously owned by a man who used to date his future wife in it, and he restored it in the 1980s. It's got a 312 Y-block engine. I've read that in 1957 there were 15,277 made, but this is obviously the best one.
I'm Big Mike Muniz, and welcome to my garage.
What you are looking at here is my 1973 Toyota TE27 Corolla LeVin rally car. This is a FIA certified Group N rally car, and what makes this thing really special is what's under the hood. This is a rare race engine by TRD, never in any production car. This is called the 152E. This particular engine came out of a IMSA GTU Celica that was campaigned back in the 80s, producing 310 horsepower to the flywheel. The slide injectors have been replaced. Carburation, 48. So it's a lot easier to tune, and also a lot easier to drive in a rally. Running TRD rally wheels with gravel tires currently. Interior wise, we've got OMP WRCR rally seats with 6-point harness, OMP steering wheel, and of course the period correct TRD rally computer and the Jeco rally timer, even a CB radio. Well, enough of that. Let's take this thing for a little spin.
Compartment, Mercedes-Benz 190SL, a large window hardtop, 1961, red interior, startup. Thank you.
To California. This is my garage and I have my two beautiful cars, my Austin Mini to my right and my beautiful 1964 and a half Mustang with a high performance motor in there. Four racing gas caps, MSC, disc brakes. It runs beautiful, it runs great. Pony interior, Papillion pony interior. And it's going deep inside to look at it. It runs great. Let's appreciate, we love these two vehicles, and hopefully more cars will come along with one in life. Okay, come and join us.
Hello, adios. This is my Shelby GT350. It's a 1966 model, car A89. This car shows in the SAC registry as having been on fire at least twice in its life. Car 889 has been completely restored and is unique in the sense that it has several of the early 66 features. These 10-spoke wheels were even on the original sales order. Car 889 has been restored to such a high level that it's been to the SAC convention and received silver status. I hope you enjoyed seeing my Shelby. Thank you for watching. This is my 1967 Shelby GT500. This car is car 2714 for 67, and you will see it features factory air condition, which was a rare option for these cars. This car also is interesting because you rarely saw air conditioning with the 4-speed, and this is a completely authentic restoration. One of the things that I really like about the 67s was all of the scoops and additions that Shelby made for the model year. I hope you enjoyed seeing my 67.
Hello, so two cars to share with you today. A Peugeot 106 Rally from 1997, a little French car. Let's take a look in the inside. Very basic and sporty. A very fun car to drive. And the other one, bigger one, is a Mitsubishi Lancer Evo 10 from 2008, and this is NRS version. Let's take a look also on the inside of this one. And you will see it is also very basic, with two bucket seats, Recaro seats, manual gearbox, and that's it. And so both these cars are used as daily drivers and track days cars. Bye.
Greetings to you, Petersen family. Thought I'd give you a look here at my 68 Ford Mustang. We purchased it in 74. My dad paid $799 for it. He drove it till 2002. He passed away. That time I inherited the car. Didn't look quite like this though. I've spent the last 15, 20 years restoring it, bringing it back to its beautiful looks. As you see, what we have here, candy apple red. 68 Mustang Coupe, 289 4-speed, deluxe interior, upper and lower consoles, power steering, manual four-wheel brakes, drums all the way around, and wire wheel covers. That set of options makes this a one-of-one Mustang built in 1968. Since then, however, it's been upgraded a little bit. Now has a Dakota digital dash, TMI sport seats, full Dynamatted interior, 347 stroker V8, 5-speed, and 3-yo gears in the rear end. Runs down the road real nice. This is my daily driver. Of course, if that's my daily driver, I must have a toy also. Here's the toy. 65 Sunbeam Tiger. Doesn't get any better than this. 289 balanced, blueprinted. Just put a 5-speed in it and picked it up yesterday from the shop. Tell you, it's really a sweet little car. And by the way, my name's Daniel. This is my Tiger. Welcome to my neighborhood.
This is my 1969 Jaguar XKE Coupe. This car was originally black and we turned it red. The car was completely rotisserie restored. During the restoration, we added the carburation from the earlier Series 1 car and changed a few other minor things under the hood. The car also was upgraded with a Tremec 5-speed, which makes it far more drivable. The XKE Coupe is, for the 60s, probably the best driving car. I hope you enjoyed it.
This is my 1970 Subaru 360 van. It came with a 25 horsepower two-cylinder engine. Now it has a 175 horsepower Hayabusa engine with modern suspension and brakes. Doing quite a bit of welding and body work on it, stretching the wheelbase. It runs and drives at this point.
Welcome to California. This is my garage and I have my two beautiful cars, my Austin Mini to my right and my beautiful 1964 and a half Mustang.
Daily driver, it runs great.
Nice beautiful black interior, white stripes in the back. We call this our Ching Ching because it's a wild mosquito for if you translate it from Spanish to English.
This is my E55 AMG 2002. You can see from the license plate that it's Waters AMG. I've had this car since 2013, bought it from a friend, and it has 133,000 miles and is a great Corvette beater of its day and drives well.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Big Mike Muniz and you are looking at my 1973 Toyota TE27 Corolla Levin, Japanese domestic model, running on vintage PRD Tosco wheels. It's a shot of the interior. And the 2TG engine, Yamaha head. Let's give this thing a couple of revs. And let's go for a quick drive on this baby.
Diane from the Utah Valley Model A Club with her 1974 Silver Shadow Rolls Royce.
Thanks for viewing my classic 1978 Fiat Spider convertible. I purchased this car about 2 years ago through an eBay auction. The car was in great overall condition, but there were some dings and dents in the body, which has since been restored to its original blue color and all the dents removed. You can see that I've also had a hand-painted pinstripe added to the car to accent the interior. There was nothing wrong with the interior, so that remains unchanged. The motor was in great condition. However, I have put in an electric fuel pump, a new radiator, and have had the carburetor restored. Thank you for viewing my Fiat Spider.
Today I'm going to show you my 1978 Mustang II King Cobra. This is an unrestored survivor car, original striping, still has its 302 V8 with all of its emission controls. This is a factory air car, and it is its original paint, striping, and interior. Now, when is the last time that you have seen a 78 Mustang II King Cobra in this condition?
1986 Citroen 2CV modified, one of two built in Switzerland. The front is a copy of a Traction Avant. The back is made into a station wagon. The car is powered by a 2CV two-cylinder Boxster air-cooled engine with a roller crank, Hemi heads and pistons, developing 28 horsepower and 50 pounds of torque.
In 1964, the Ford GT struggled to be competitive at the Le Mans race. Carroll Shelby took over the program at the end of the season, and he also took over the Mustang program and created a legend using his friends Ken Miles, Pete Brock, and Phil Remington. The racing Mustang they created was the GT350R, and it competed dominantly with exotic European models of the period. GT350 production carried on with each model year through the 1968 and 1969 iterations. In 1970, the model year stopped. A half century later, Ford engineers created their own homage to the original GT350R. So they created their own, with the styling cues reminiscent of the 1968 5 through 69 model years. 21st century technology became OEM equipment on this working person's supercar. And like in the mid-60s, it took on the best of Europe and their exotics. In IMSA GTS class, they competed and won against mid-engine McLarens, Porsches, Mercedes-AMG. At the heart of this Mustang is a 5.3-liter flat-plane crank V8. Produces 526 horsepower to push this pony through its paces. Push the button and listen to some of the visceral sounds that the engineers made for the nickname Voodoo Engine. This is HR 421. An Avalanche Gray 2017 model. A Ford's gift to the racing world. And this is the face of Ford Racing. Although this is probably what the competition is used to seeing.
Is my 1999 Mercedes CLK 430 with the AMG luxury package. And that includes, of course, chrome wheels, which you see here, a pristine interior with 125,000 miles on it, 0 to 60. In only 6 seconds out of a V8 motor generating 275 horsepower. The car is a sports car in every manner, shape, or form. Different size tires, front and rear, for better handling. And that's it.
Hi guys, this is my 2002 Porsche Carrera C4S. It's finished in black. It's got just over 100,000 miles, and the IMS was done, and the car runs perfectly. And today I'm going to be running the back roads of California and heading up to Santa Barbara and Ojai with a bunch of like-minded car enthusiasts who are glad to be free of the yoke of staying at home. Have fun. Thank you. Bye.
From Arlington, Virginia, this is my Porsche 911 Carrera S. It is from 2009. It's got the PDK transmission. It is, I think, what Porsche calls aqua blue, and did a few mods. I did an iPhone adapter so I could stream music, and the other modification is on the back I have a New England Patriots bumper sticker. Thanks everyone.
This is Sharon standing by our 1969 emerald green Bronco, which we are proud to have in our collection. It was restored by Bronco Hut in Castle Rock, Colorado. Sharon will show you the interior, which is white, very nicely done, and it has a 302 cubic inch V8 all.
Hello from West Palm Beach, Florida. This is a 1969 Chevrolet Corvair 500 Coupe. It has 28,000 original miles on it. Repainted once in the original frost green. It has the 110 horsepower engine, air-cooled flat six in the rear. And it has a nice 500 bench seat in there. Two-speed Power Glide transmission. My great aunt bought this new. It has 28,000 miles. It's my occasional daily driver, and I call her Peg.
These are my two Saab stories that actually make me quite happy. First is a 1969 Saab 96. It has a few unique features, like windows that pivot up and down in the front, a four on the column shifter, and then I found out that they made a sports car called the Saab Sonnet 3. This is 1971. It's an all fiberglass body, weighs under 2,000 pounds. Both of these cars were made for the US market. The owner that restored it about 12 years ago calls this color black cherry, and I especially like the matching crushed velvet seats. Yeah, baby.
This is my 1973 Volkswagen. It's powered by a 1600cc air-cooled engine, and it even has a factory 8-track player. All the things came in three colors in 73, white, orange, and my favorite, sunshine yellow. It has four removable side curtains, a fold-down convertible top, and a lay-flat front windshield. It also has a roll bar, and it even has four doors that can be removed. I have owned this thing since 1984. That's over 36 years of fun driving in Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and Florida. Are you looking for a fun car? I think you may have found it.
Hey everyone, my name is Adam and I'm reporting in from Sunrise, Florida with my 2015 Volkswagen GTI. I've had the car for 6 years now and my overall mission has been to keep it OEM plus. To most people, it's just another VW, but to those who know, they'll pick up on all the details. The highlights include European headlights and taillights, as well as Golf R power folding mirrors and Golf R wheels. I also have a GTI Club Sport S exhaust. It's a very limited European-only model. And I'm running a Stage 1 tune from my good friends at MTM, a very well-known tuner out of Germany. Puts the car at about 300 horsepower, coupled with an Eventuri intake system. On the interior, the centerpiece is a full MIB2 infotainment and active info display retrofit. That's a configuration not offered in the U.S. at all. So it's great to see everyone and their cars on here, and thanks for the feature on mine.
Hello, everyone. My name is Brad Smith. I live in Carpinteria, California. I'm doing a video of my 39 Ford Woody. I bought this car in 1996 from a little old lady in Burbank. It's got a Columbia rear end, 39 transmission, got a built flathead, a quarter 5/16 flathead with two barrel carburetors on it. Thank you very much, and I hope that Petersen enjoys seeing this.
Hey guys, my name is Sam Del Chiapo. This is the San Gabriel Valley region of the PCA. This is my 1987 factory turbo look, and down we go.
Hi, I'm Steve Bitter with the San Gabriel Valley PCA. This is our car, Lori and Stevens, the 2004 4S.
Hello, Paul Morin, San Gabriel Valley region. This is my 2014 911 Special Anniversary Edition, 50th anniversary.
I'm Gary and Arlen Robinson, PCA, San Gabriel Valley, and this is my 1970 911T.
Renee Cortez, PCA member. This is my 2014 paint to sample Mexico Blue C4S.
Hi, Robbie Sandu. This is my 2014 Cayenne GTS.
I'm Michael Da Silva, PCA San Gabriel Valley region, 2013 Carrera Agate Gray.
Hi, Rusty B, PCA, 2005 Turbo S.
1936 Chevrolet Cabriolet all-metal customized convertible. It was a previous Haggerty Insurance poster car when this vehicle was all stock. Has a dropped and narrowed Packard grille, dropped headlights, 350 Chevy engine, automatic transmission, Mustang II front suspension, custom interior, rumble seat, customized throughout.
My 1941 Buick Roadmaster four-door convertible, looking almost original except for the wheels. It's a low mileage car with the original paint, complete original interior, leather interior, and the dash and everything is still in very nice condition. Under the hood,
this is our 1955 original 239 Y-block with the original 4-speed granny tranny. It's an F350 flatbed with an original flatbed from 1955. The flatbed has been cut shorter and sectioned and then custom made with all this wood. And this is the truck.
Hello, my name is Michael Siganoff, and I'm showing to you today our two Astons. We got a his and hers. Mine is the coupe with a hard top, of course, and my wife's the white one behind as a roadster. The coupe is a 2007 Aston Martin V8 Vantage, and the roadster is a 2008 V8 Vantage. We've had them for several years now. Like I said, his and hers, she loves her convertible. She loves driving around with that. And then of course, I love my car because it's more of a coupe that everybody knows about. It's a purist type car, I guess. So there they are, both of them. We were just going through Carbon Canyon. We're here at a park right now. We'll just park together and make this little video. So like I said, his and hers, Aston Martins. Also wanted to show you the rear of the cars. You can see we have his and hers vanity plates, Aston UK and UK Aston. Just kind of a mirror images of each other.
Hi, my name's Debbie. I'm from Southern California, and I'm going to give you a little look at my 1959 Ford Fairlane 500 Galaxy Sunliner convertible. Let's take a look. I purchased the car in 1985 from the original owner. There's never been any body damage. It's in really great shape. I got custom plates when I first bought it because I was a Huntington Beach local at the time. It's not stock. There's some changes. There's a Cleveland engine in it. Interior is pretty much original. A couple changes here and again. The convertible top is on a hydraulic system, which is really easy. Just push of a button. It's really a beautiful little ride, and it's been in a lot of events and photo shoots. So let's give it a start so you can hear what it sounds like. Just gotta love that sound, huh? Thanks for letting me share my car with you. Hope you enjoyed it.
This is the 2015 Porsche Cayman GTS. Painted in carmine red over black leather and Alcantara interior. This car is so much fun to drive at the track and through the canyons.
I'm Tommy Scalera, and this is Dixie, our 1962 Thunderbird convertible in Raven Black. She's got a black interior, black top, swing-away steering wheel, and a 390 engine under the hood. We bought Dixie back in 1999, and for 20 years she was part of the family, going on numerous road trips, car shows, and family events. In fact, our daughter Ruby learned to drive on her. But after 20 years, it was time to move on. And after spending most of her life in New Jersey, she now drives along country roads outside of Paris, France. Not bad for a Jersey girl.
Porsche 928 S4. 30-year-old car, 24,000 original miles, original paint even, without a scratch or a swirl mark in it. This is what the engine looked like from the factory. Still has the original finish on the intake valve covers. It even has the mythical jump post cover that is usually missing. It's one of the last great GTs ever made, and it is a delight to drive.
Good morning, Petersen Cars and Coffee. My name is Wade Kawasaki, and I'm here to present my 1966 VW 21-window beach cruiser bus. This Samba was actually an original 21-window bus with the European sunroof. It got a complete nut and bolt restoration, mechanical, electrical, the interior and exterior, and it's ready to hit the beaches of Southern California. All right, that's it.
This is our 1969 Trans Am vintage Dan Gurney Shelby Boss 302 tribute race car built here in the state of Texas by two gentlemen named Jim Rice, David Nolan. We are so proud to have in our collection. You can see it is an SVRA gold medallion, a certified car. There is the gold medallion. Is powered by a 302 cubic inch V8 engine.
This is my 1976 Triumph TR7. This is a Victory Edition model, unique to the North American market only.
sold in 1976. The wheels, vinyl roof, and stripe graphics are part of the package. It's an all-original car with 41,000 miles.
This is a 1998 Porsche 911 in Glacier White, and I just want to show you some of the features of this car. To put the gas, you have to pull this handle, and this is for the gas, this is for the windshield wiper liquid. To open the engine compartment, you have to pull this handle, and when you lift this up, you will see the big fan, which shows that this is an air-cooled car, not a water-cooled. It uses actually the oil to cool the engine down. And when you want to check the engine level fluid, you have to pull this handle when the engine is running, not when it's a stop. And this is where you put the oil in the car. Thank you.
This is a 1948 Dodge 1-ton model B1D, that's Bravo 1 Delta. We purchased it from the original owner's grandson. And it has less than 40,000 original miles and the original paint. One of the things we love the most about it is the interior. It is newly appointed with stainless steel dashboard. And our favorite story is the corn cob pipe of the original owner is still in the sun visor. It will remain a permanent fixture, reminding us of this wonderful man and this beautiful truck.
2001 Honda S2000, which makes it an AP1. In 2004, Honda came out with the AP2. They say that's a better car, but the AP1 is a better S2000. A little more track focused, revs to 9,000 RPM, doesn't even have a clock, and just a great car overall. I have a couple of mods, K&N filter, injectors, exhaust. Makes it sound a little better, doesn't really add to the performance. But I do have a modern ECU, and the VTEC is tuned to kick in sooner to give it more low-end torque. I love the car, it's my daily driver. Like the guys on the forum, I have no intention of selling it.
My name is Lonnie Paul Johnson, and this is my 1955 Ford Thunderbird. As you can see, she's been restored to its original showroom condition, every last detail down to the original 6-volt system. The first owner of this car was Maxine Andrews of the Andrews Sisters. She bought the car new in 1955 at Santa Monica Ford. In 1956, Fritz Freleng, the famous director of the early Warner Brothers cartoons, bought it and owned it for many years. It eventually ended up with a man named Stanley Harlan, who restored it in 2012. When Stanley passed away a few years ago, he left it to his daughter, who sold it to me. And I love showing her off every chance I get. I hope to see you guys out on the road again real soon.
Hey, Petersen. Bonnie with Zelectric here. We love this car. This is our award-winning 1958 anthracite ragtop. It's all electric, powered with Tesla batteries located up front where the gas tank once was, and tucked in there behind the back seat. The electric motor mounts to a rebuilt transaxle and delivers almost 3 times the original horsepower. It is so much fun to drive. The shifter still works, so the gear that you're in actually determines how much instant torque you get. Mostly, you could just drive from 0 to 60 totally in third. But if you want to blow the doors off your neighbor, start off in first. This is a pan-off restoration. Everything that moves here has been restored or replaced. And brakes are upgraded to disc, custom leather seats, white wall tires, and the carpet is German square weave. All the lights are bright 12-volt LEDs. So you can actually see where you're going. Plus, you can charge up just about anywhere, at any public charging station, or even next to your toaster. Okay, thanks for watching.
Welcome from Fountain Valley, California. I am a member of Corvettes of Southern California, and this is my 2017 Z06. I ordered it with the 3LZ package, engine build experience, buyer's tour, and museum delivery. Here you see my name as the engine builder. The engine was built October 4th, and on October 5th, my wife and I watched as she was being built. She has a two-tone adrenaline red and black interior, and the plaque on the console shows that I did the museum delivery. I hope you enjoyed this video and save the wave.
Hello everyone, this is the 2018 Camaro SS released for the 50th anniversary of Hot Wheels. It is now a two-tone car. It has a glossy orange finish that shines more than the original color, and it has gray accents along with the gray roof now. It has LED lights that change with a Bluetooth controlled phone. And here's what it sounds like when it's turned on and being revved. Thank you.
I got my keys, I've got my coffee, and I'm ready for virtual cars and coffee. Everything tastes better in a Porsche mug.
I'm Dennis Hubrix, member of the Rally Sport Region Porsche Club of America. This is my 2000 Carrera 911 Cabrio. I've owned the car for a little less than a year. Bought it in September of 2019. It's basically all original, no modifications. The only new parts that have ever gone on it are fair wear and tear parts. Bought it from an owner who had it for about 13 years. Had 40,000 miles on when I acquired it. It's got 3.4 liter flat six, six-speed manual gearbox, Arctic silver paint with a Metropole blue interior and matching Metropole blue convertible top. That's it.
This 2001 Boxster S for a couple of years. We bought it when we became empty nesters and realized that we could go on car trips in something other than a minivan or an SUV. My wife wanted a blue car with the top that went down and a manual transmission. I agreed with all of those criteria, so this is what we ended up getting. 2001 Boxster S.
This is my 1986 normally aspirated 944 track car. Streetable, but a track car. Very little to give it away on the outside. It looks just like a non-turbo 944, except for the Steinel decal on the back panel here, who is a pretty well-known tuner down in Ohio for 944s. Its track focus becomes evident when you open up the door, which is devoid of pretty much everything, and then turn toward the interior, which is fitted with race seats, 6-point harnesses, a roll bar, and not much else. It is streetable in that it has working lights, a working stereo, and best of all, a working air conditioner.
Well, good morning, everybody. This is my 72 911. I bought it in 2013 out of California. It was all in pieces. The guy had started a restoration on it, but he kind of ran out of time and money. So I bought it in that spring, and we finally got it on the road last year. I'm a big fan of the 72s. The car was originally Bahia Red, and we painted it blood orange. It's also known as Tangerine. And fun to drive. It's got a 3.2 Carrera motor in it. And carburetors. And it's a ball to drive. It's kind of neat because we got signatures from Hurley Haywood, Brian Redman, and Vic Elford at the Porsche gathering over at St. John's. That's it. Thanks.
1986 911, all stock.
For Ann Arbor's Cars and Coffee. So we're PCA members.
This is a 1996 Toyota MR2 SW20 RAV4. It has a 3SGE engine. It's naturally aspirated. It has 173 horsepower and 185 newton meters of torque. As of now, the car is fully stock, so no modifications. And I purchased the car very recently, after a period in which it was kept standing still in a private collection for roughly 5 years.
Hey
Here is our 2006 350Z Roadster. Living here on the California Central Coast, top down is a year-round experience. Operation of the top has fascinated many people, so watch as we bring it down to show the interior. Like all our cars, I could not leave it alone, so now the interior has custom leather upholstery, wood trim, and an Alpine stereo with GPS and a backup camera. Not content with interior upgrades, it also has a Stillen supercharger, intercooler, and Stillen exhaust. The car went from being fast to insanely fast. In fact, it even startled our son, who at the time had a Porsche Boxster S. The car is a daily driver and has almost 81,000 miles on it.
We are up here in Junction City. We had to cancel our Function for Junction car event that we would have over this weekend. So here's the next best thing is we have our car get together on Wednesday nights up here in Junction City. This is Jim Foster. I got a 68 Ford Mustang that I've had for 44 years. And I've put over 600,000 miles on it. Next on our list of cars, we have...
Hi, I'm Steve Snyder. I live in Eugene. This is my mine and my wife's 69 Chevelle. We've had it about 20 years. It's got about 70,000 miles on it.
Perfect. Corey, tell us about your car.
Bryson, go ahead. This is Bryson's truck.
So this is a 72 Ford F-250. We cut down the bed and it's a Crown Vic cop car.
How long have you had it?
We had it for about a year. That's how long it took us to put it together.
Okay, anything else you want to say about it?
Nope, that's about it.
Okay, we'll go over next set of people here.
Are we supposed to tell who we are?
Pardon?
Are we supposed to tell
who are you? Tell us your names.
Okay. Hi, we're Doug and Jane Aikson, and this is our 1966 Chevy Malibu, two-door hardtop. We found it, gave 2,000 for it. And done all the restoration on it. It's got a 1970 Chevy Corvette 350, 4.40 over with RV cam. It has a stock two-speed transmission, totally redone.
And did all the work, interior and everything.
Yep.
How long have you had it?
We've had it since 2001. 2001.
Perfect, almost 20 years.
Yes.
Almost 20 years.
Excellent, great, thank you. Next over here we got... Name, please?
Frank Zonneben.
And what do you have here?
It's a 32 Ford.
Uh-huh.
I've owned it for almost 20 years now. And the body was picked up out of Phoenix, Arizona. And out of the 20 years, this last summer was the first summer it actually hit the road. So it's kind of exciting to see it move on its own power.
Very good. Thank you very much. Over here. We have a Shelby Cobra here. Yeah. Gerald is the gentleman's name that owns this vehicle here. And he's the one that put it together. And we see him driving it around all the time up here in Junction City and Eugene, Oregon. Here are some other cars that we have over here that I'm going for. So, what do we have over here with the purple car? George, tell me about your car.
Oh, I'm very sorry. This is the...
Tell me about your car.
This is a 1932 three-window Ford. Old school. 324 cubic inch. 3.2s. Cam. Home built.
Okay, very good. I see him up here all the time, too. Next over here, we got you the owner of this car here?
I am, yeah.
All right, give me your name, sir.
Jim Westbrooks.
Jim Westwood, and the vehicle
Brooks. You... Westbrooks.
Westbrooks, sorry.
1948 Chevrolet panel.
Uh-huh. And how long have you had it?
I built it. I probably had it 6-7 years.
Okay. And we see it driving around here every once in a while too, right?
Oh yeah.
As always, perfect.
What do you have?
Okay.
What's this?
Ready.
What's this? This?
Ready.
This? What's this?
It is a Hot Wheel car.
Okay, what's this?
Ready.
A Lamborghini?
Yeah.
What is this?
A Bentley.
No, what is this?
Bentley.
A Bentley car?
Yeah.
What's this?
Bentley.
This?
A buggy.
Lamborghini? What's that?
McLaren.
A McLaren?
Yeah.
What is this?
No.
You don't know? What is this?
M3.
M3?
Yeah.
What is that?
M3.
What is this?
A big Mustang.
A Mustang?
Yeah.
What is that? A Lamborghini? What is that?
It's fire.
And what is that? What's this one?
Right,
a Mercedes?
Right here.
Good work. Way to go, James.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to click subscribe, comment, and like for more videos like this one.